Hi and welcome everyone. In the previous video, we used an Azure Virtual Desktop Gold Image virtual machine with all our company apps installed, and we captured that image for future use in the Azure Image Gallery, and we rolled that gold image out to our AVD environment session hosts in the Spoke network. In this video, we will show you a different solution, and we will use modern device management with Intune to manage our Windows session hosts. We will package up an application to push out via Intune and also show available templates to use for Azure Virtual Desktop Session Hosts, which has configuration options like watermark and screen capture protection for AVD. Together with locking down options in Intune to configure AVD Windows desktops to block users from running certain applications, such as the command line, PowerShell, registry editor, hiding the control panel, which you don't really want your users to have access to in a Windows session. So this solution, it's another option using Intune to deploy our apps rather than the AVD golden image we deployed in another video. Links are in the description for that video if you haven't seen it yet. And if you normally manage your environment using Active Directory and group policy, then this will replace that using modern device management with devices joined to EnterID and managed by Intune. As always, if you like the content here, please like, subscribe and comment, and that will be most appreciated to grow the channel. Thank you. Okay, so as explained, we are not using a gold image here to install our apps and roll out to our Windows 11 hosts. Like the previous video on Azure Virtual Desktop, we will manage our Windows 11 session hosts with Intune. First off, we will create a new security group in the Azure portal, which will contain our Windows 11 session hosts. The membership type will be a dynamic device, and we will use a query for our devices to add to the group. That query will be a display name which starts with AVD, as our session hosts are named and start with AVD. We only have one at the moment for the purpose of this demo, but as we roll more out with the AVD naming convention, then they will automatically get added to the group. This group will be used to deploy our applications later on in Intune. So let's validate our first AVD host VM and confirm it gets added to the group okay. Okay, good. So now we go over to the Intune portal, and under devices, we can see our Intune host listed. If you need to set up Intune, then I do have another video in the description how to autopilot devices into Intune, so check that out too. Okay, so under App, Windows, here we can package our apps and configure them to push out to our devices. But first we need to package the app as a .intune win file, and we will do that in the next section, packaging up Notepad++ as an example. Now let's package up an application using the Intune WinApp utility. So first off, we will download our app. In this demo, we will use Notepad++, and then we will download the Intune WinApp utility from GitHub. And this is a Microsoft packaging tool which converts application installation files into .intuneWin format for the use within Intune. Now we create a folder structure as follows with our downloads of Notepad, Intune WinApp util, and an output directory which will contain the .intuneWin format package file. We run Intune WinApp util exe and specify the source folder of the Notepad app, then the Notepad file name, and then the output folder, and we don't specify a catalog folder. Okay, good. So we now have our Intune Win Notepad packaged app that we can use in the Intune portal to roll out to our Windows desktops. So let's do that next and add this app to Intune. Now let's add the Intune Win Notepad packaged app that we created in the last section. So in Intune, we go to Apps, Windows, and click Add, and we choose the app type of Windows app Win32. We select our Intune Win Notepad file, and then we enter a publisher name. And there are other options here to fill in, such as version, information URL, etc. For the install command, we enter as follows, specifying the exe of the app and the slash s switch, which is the switch to run the install in silent mode for our users. And we also enter an uninstall command. And we also have other options here, such as time for the install to finish and device restart behavior. We will leave these as default. So we click next and we select the operating system architecture as x64-bit with a minimum required operating system to install the app on. We can add other requirements that the app needs to meet here as well, such as file, registry or script. And for a detection rule, we will add a manual rule specifying the presence of the app file or folder exists. We can add other dependencies here too, together with what this app will supersede. And finally, we add our app device dynamic group, which contains our Windows devices to deploy the app to. And we leave as default to show notifications and deploy the app as soon as possible. Now, when we check the Windows Session Host desktop, we can see the Notepad app was installed successfully with a notification. Also, we see reporting in Intune that the app was installed to our device. Now, let's take this a step further and show templates for Azure Virtual Desktop Session Hosts using the new watermark and screen capture protection, together with locking down applications such as command line, PowerShell, hiding the control panel, which you don't really want your users to have access to. If you normally manage your environment using old methods like Active Directory and Group Policy, then this can replace that, as you will find that most of the old group policies available in Active Directory are now available using modern device management, with devices joined to Entra ID and managed by Intune. That's now the preferred method for management. A lot of my customers are migrating and shifting to a pure Entra ID cloud identity and Intune modern device management, and have decommissioned traditional Active Directory and group policy as they no longer require this in their environments. This is possible if you don't run old legacy applications on-prem, which use Kerberos, LDAP, authentication, etc. Of course, every environment is different, but this is possible if you can migrate your old apps to cloud-native services, but all depends on your environment, services used, applications, and authentication. Okay, back to it. So if we go to Intune, Devices, and under Configuration, we can create new policies and also have the option to import ADMX administrative templates containing the metadata of a Windows group policy, if we need to. So we select a platform, Windows 10 and later, and a profile type of the settings catalog. And let's name this and click next to take a look at the settings we have available. As you can see, there is a vast amount, similar to what you would see in Active Directory group policy. So let's select some under admin templates and Windows components to turn off, for example, the Windows Store application, where we don't want our users to view the Windows Store on a Windows end device to install applications from the store. We also have templates here for Azure Virtual Desktop, such as watermarking and screen capture properties. Watermarking, together with screen capture protection, it helps prevent sensitive information from being captured on AVD session hosts. So what users and admins will see is a QR code, and it appears as a watermark within the AVD session, and it contains a connection ID or device ID of the remote session that admins can use to trace the session. With screen capture protection, remote content is automatically blocked in screenshots and screen sharing. We will also prevent registry editing tools from running in the Windows session. And access to the command prompt, we can specify a list of applications by name, such as PowerShell.exe or Notepad.exe as an example. And lastly, we will prohibit access to the control panel. We will apply that to our AVD session host group, which contains our Windows devices. Now, with all that in place, let's check out our end user devices, and we can see that these policies have been applied and warped marking is enabled. Okay, great. So hope you enjoyed the video. Let us know in the comments how you are updating your session hosts in your environment. Are you still using traditional Active Directory and group policy, maybe in a hybrid model with Entra ID identity, gold images for your session hosts, or fully migrated now to modern device management in Intune? Don't forget to like and subscribe, and see you next time. Bye for now.